YouTube, what's up, man? Every night, twitch.tv/dub. We play Madden. Let me know if you ever caught a stream before or you haven't. Let me know below. Are you in a stream often? What's your Twitch name? Tell me your Twitch handle below in the comments. Because a lot of times you guys say, what's up, man? The stream was great. And I don't really know. Sometimes your YouTube name is different than your Twitch name. Your Twitter name is different than your Twitch name. And nobody lets me know. So what is your Twitch tag? Put that below and let me know if you've ever caught a stream before. Also, man, this game was one of the most high-octane, entertaining games that I played in the last month, honestly. And I'm playing against strong close, I flex by near, far, anything with two wide receivers, two running backs, and a tight end. I like to put a lot of people in the box. I like to run 3-4. And you guys know a lot of my videos, I rely a lot on my D-tackle, Miles Garrett. He is 99 overall. He has pass rush elite, enforcer, secure tackler, and run stopper. Those are the four abilities I have on him. Now, I blitz seven people most every play against the strong close or eye close, mostly because I want to leave Miles Garrett with a one-on-one. When I blitz seven people, that means all the running backs are occupied, all the linemen are occupied, the tight end is occupied, whoever he blocks is occupied, right? So what that does, it allows Miles Garrett a one-on-one with the center. Now, if the center has abilities, maybe he'll stonewall him, but I feel like with no ability center, Miles Garrett will instant shed him before the quarterback can take a five-step drop 50% of the time. So when I play these sets, I pretty much rely on this. It is a big part, but you guys know how ridiculous pass rush elite is, and so I don't think it's that big of a hope relying on it. I feel like if it's one-on-one with a non-chemmed offensive lineman, he should beat him 50% of the time, right? And I feel like that's fair, and that's what normally happens. That's how I play defense. This game, it was a battle. Miles kind of got his ass whooped. And I'm gonna let you guys know as you watch this, I want you guys to watch Miles Garrett and give me a 1-10 on his performance in the game. He made some plays, but like I said, my whole defense is pretty much revolving around him. But this game was high octane. Once again, let me know your Twitch tag below in the chat and follow that Twitch. We play every night. Weekend League is about to pop off, but I hope you guys enjoy this gameplay. One of the best of the month. All right, boys, so we're getting the ball first. We have Moss, so we're going to throw this little slant, kind of a decoy. We use Moss as a decoy. It's probably his best thing. This guy's running a little 3-4 bear. I'll be honest, I think 3-4 bear has no ability to cover spread out sets. It just doesn't. There's only a single high safety every single play. If you're going to run 3-4 bear, I suggest you blitz 6, 7, or 8 people, not 4 or 5. I feel like it just can't cover with that many linebackers on the field. I think that's the same thing as I overthrow the crossing route right there. I feel like that's the same thing with any 3-4 situation, any 3-4 pass rush. If you're going to be in 3-4, you should be sending a lot of people because the linebackers can't cover. And right here, we're going to throw an out route. That's a big thing about 3-4 bear. It can't cover that. So they're going to have to adjust to the out route because there's a single high safety. It can't really be covered too. And right here, he's going to put his corner in the cloud. I'm going to make a perfect read. And Calvin Johnson smokes the touchdown right there, forcing me to kick 3. I don't know what that was about, but like I said, he put his outside corner in the cloud. I put a streak, pass led it perfect. Should have been 7-0. We'll take 3-0. 4th and 7, not worth it. Got to get your points. You got to get points on the board. That way, at least see his offense, see what he's working with. And this is strong close. They motion out this guy. And right there, first play of the game, Miles Garrett does what he's supposed to do. Next play, he's kind of getting stonewalled, but he gets rid of the ball pretty quickly. I want you to watch it. My whole defense, I'm sending 7, hoping to get that one-on-one with Miles Garrett. And so he pops him. And right there, Michael Irvin, a playmaker, pops Pat Pete. Most of the time in these routes or these formations, I expect corner route or post route from those solo receivers. The fact he put him on a streak, if you saw my user, I jumped down for a corner route. But he was on a streak, beat me over the top. I gave up a free 7. It's a little bit rough, and then on top of a free 7, Clowney comes off of the screen and makes Michael Vick fumble. Trying to make a big play right there. I had 15 yards on a scramble. Just get down. But and once again, I'm sending everybody. Nobody really gets home, but he panics, loses a cool 15 yards on a sack. 2nd and 27, throws this little slant to Okoye. They motion out this guy, and what it does with your man coverage, and there's the corner route. Boom. Touchdown, Pat Pete. Pat Pete has given up 2 touchdowns. I don't want you guys to come here and kill Pat Pete. I still think he's the best corner in the game. And this is my question. This is how I feel about corners. There's not a single DB in the world that's going to stop the hot routed corner route. There's just not, especially in man press. There's just nothing you can do about it. So as a defensive player, you have to know that's going to happen. You know, you're going to get whooped by those hot route, by the post or the corner route. You are going to get whooped every single time. Right there, I just got screamed at. Going back to motion block, we don't need to send out everybody. Right there, a little corner route roll out, crossing route, corner route, Trey Y flex. If you're playing against this man, don't let that guy catch the ball. The middle, the inside slot receiver, just if you user him, you will have great success against Trey Y flex. Right there, he blitzes again, trying to play off this cloud flat on the outside. Here I switch my receivers, bang, up top, Randy Moss touchdown. That's what I mean. There's no, if you put your outside corner in a cloud, you cannot play cover two. We exploited that, get the touchdown right there. So we're back down four. This game is high octane, I'm telling you. Miles Garrett, I once again blitzing seven here. He's going. I'm looking for the he was looking for the deep post right there, but finally Julius Peppers gets in there, get a little bit of pressure. Next play, he's going to be looking to scramble Keith Bullock. I'm ready to get Palomalu back on my team, just to have 98 speed at every linebacker spot. Here he goes with the post inside. I actually put my corner in a cloud flat there to try to stop that corner route, but he went post there. Good play, fourth down, just snap throw over the middle of the field. Well, here he goes, throwing in the flat a little bit. He did this enough to make me respect it. It wasn't the whole offense, but just every once in a while, sneaking that running back out in the flat is annoying. And here we go again, just throwing right in the middle of my face. Drops it because Gronkowski doesn't have an ability. Next play, we wrap him up. Get him to a third and long right here before half. I use a timeout, try to get the ball back. Here he goes, goes up top. And this is Julio Jones. Because I send that much pressure, he pretty much isolates Julio Jones on Taylor Mays all game. And that's just not a match. As good as Taylor Mays is, that's just not a matchup you want to have. And that matchup is going to haunt me this entire game. But we have 30 seconds. We got one timeout. He switched his defense, went to more of a 3-3-5, more coverage defense, less pressure. And we got to take advantage of that. We roll out here, smack that corner route, Randy Moss, boom. Nice little 26-yard gain. First and 10, one more play, we'll get in the field goal range. Daggery bags it up pretty good right there. So I'm going to switch my play up a little bit. Pull one of these plays out of my back pocket with the tight end on the in route. And I get this nice, crispy playmaker right there. Vic throws it on run, possession catch. Make sure I had that. I want to note, I'm going to spike right here because I'm cool with a field goal. Run the clock off, and we're going to spike this here at 3 seconds. Just to be able to get my field goal. I'm cool. I mean, the game is not going that well. It's 21-13. He actually gets the ball at half, but it's a one possession game. We will fight. I believe in Miles Garrett. I believe in sending seven people at under center, because if we can win that matchup of the center and the D tackle fast, we can get after the quarterback. So I've played enough to know that this defensive philosophy works. It does. And if you trust what you do, that's the best thing to do. Even some games it looks like, man, that's not working, this isn't working. Just trust what you know, trust your mind. And this defense, I trust in it. He's 9-for-10 right now, absolutely frying me. Going up top again, Miles Garrett, let me know where he was. And he actually did a good job clicking on and bumping, getting position on Taylor Mays right there. But Taylor Mays gives up another touchdown to Julio Jones. So we're down 28-13. But if you see my stream, man, we've been down before. And we're going to fight. We're down 15 points since the third quarter. This 3-3-5, I feel like you have no shot to cover Trey Y flex in 3-3-5. Right there, we have double me. Throw the corner route, but of course we don't get our feet in. So we lose our double me. Don't get the completion. Second and 10. We're going to go back to the crossing route. Boom. Right there. Julio Jones, first down, 27-yard line. Just cooking with gas right here. Rolling out for the corner route. Dump it off to Ingram. Pick up a cool 7 yards. Second and 2. In a little read option right here to Walter Payton, picking up what we can inside the 5-yard line. And this is where we run blast right there. One thing about editing games, you get to see what the mistakes that you make, and that was one of them right there. But we will hit the little hits right there. He leaves them open. Gronkowski, touchdown, 28-20. We are fighting back. Miles Garrett, talk to me, man. I pay you a lot of money. There's a lot of coins invested in Mr. Miles Garrett, so I'm going to need you to talk to me. I'm going to need you to go ahead and make some plays, all right? Well, so like I said, that's why I trust this defense. I want to keep running it no matter how bad I'm getting torn up. We're going to keep running it here. In route right there to Michael Irvin. You're just, if you have time, you just will not cover receivers with abilities. And speaking of receivers with abilities, mama, there goes that man, Julio Jones. I actually stopped him from getting a touchdown right there. So That's always a positive. He's going to try to run the ball here. One of the reasons I stay in edge blitz too, it's run defense. You're just not going to run. And that's the one thing about these sets, man. They're good at passing because you kind of have to be in run defense. You know, and that's what makes it easier for these guys to pass, because you have to respect the run. Big tackle by Julio Jones on that post route. Holding him to three is 31-20. Getting into the fourth quarter here. We're going to dump this ball off over here to Evan Engram. Pick up a couple yards. Drags are so trash this year. But we just got to score. We're down two possessions. Let's get out of here. And we'll see right there as Julio Jones tries to tackle Michael Vick. I don't know what that was about. But let's just keep going. We got to go down here. We can take a field goal here. It'll make it a one possession game. We are down 11 points. Just taking what I can. If you don't spy Vick, I'm getting out of there. One thing, you got to make them spy, because it takes away a player from coverage or from the pass rush. There it is. So he spies, only gets through on the pass rush. I'm able to roll out easily. Randy Moss, 21 yard line. Boom. Just got to score here. Got to score. We roll out. He loses Randy Moss on the crosser. Boom. Touchdown. Just like that. It is. And we're going to need our two-point conversion to make it 31-28. Best two-point conversion play in the game is blast. There it is. Myles Garrett getting through with company. Boom, that's what I need. It hasn't been happening that much. He actually makes me audible right here to cover two, and he gets away with a scramble with Lamar Jackson. But we get him out of bounds, so that stops the clock. Gives me a little bit of hope. Third and four. He does this little table route or underneath route to Gronkowski, catches it, but it's fourth and one. Now I'll tell you, if you get a fourth and one versus me, you better be able to buckle up your chin strap, because I am sending everybody in the coach at you. I'm going to press. I'm going to get physical. I need to get off the field here. If I give up a touchdown, I give up a touchdown. I've given up about four touchdowns so far. He motions out. You man a line to get your people to man a line the right way. That's Y and RB. Fourth down. We are, like I said, I got the tight end. I got everybody just underneath here. There he is. Myles Garrett. That is something I've grown accustomed to happening to against these sets. You force that one-on-one. He gets in there. Boom. Two-minute warning. We're down by three. All we need is a touchdown. Roll out right here. He goes with a little pinch, blitzes everybody, but we hit Julio Mondulio. Touchdown. 34-31. We are up by three. Now we are up by four. We cannot give up a touchdown. Initial point, I mean, do I want to play safe or not? And once again, no pressure, and he lofts it up to Julio Jones. Taylor Mays cannot catch him. Taylor Mays got exposed. This defense, I have not gotten the pressure I want from Myles Garrett. One play, 75 yards. So we're right back where we were, down by three. Plenty of time on the clock. A minute 40. No runoff in this mode. It really makes it a little tougher to play defense, but he gets a sack. He goes back to 3-4 bear, brings a little bit more pressure. I got a motion block more. Next play, we're going to go ahead and hit this drag. Nice little swerve. We pick up 12 yards on the drag. Nice. Third and seven. We're going to go for, I believe, the corner route here. No, the crossing route, but somebody gets through, and I throw the ball away. I swear I was out of the pocket. Get intentional grounding. Forces me to a fourth and 16. Got to go for it. And the worst part about this, I get sacked on the one-yard line. Oh, my God. So if he scores a touchdown, the game is over. We got to stand up for ourselves. Hold the door. Patrick Willis, Calvin Johnson right there. Boom. Anthony Barr. I believe that's, who's that? Calvin Johnson wrapping him up with third and goal on the six. Run a little stretch again. Bang! Calvin Johnson, his stick. Forced him to three. Used all my timeouts, so we are down by six. Need a touchdown. We have the personnel to do it. We have the offense to do it. We believe in the system. Even if the system's failing us, we believe in it, because we've been here before. Now, I said, we're going to hit this little flat. Whoop, nice little swerve. Get up out of there, Julio. Juli Manduli for both of us has been killing. I don't know how I got hawked down so easily, but I went out of bounds right there. I don't have any timeouts, but there's no runoff. I have to start using some time right here. As I run right there, I have to start milking. Get inside the five-yard line with the blast. Another blast right there. Boom. Under 30 seconds. We're going to use a little bit of this time. We're going to call blast here. Try to snap this around 15 seconds. Honestly, this is going to be three blasts for me. If I get in, I get in. If not, I don't. Boom, right there. Break it to the right. Touchdown, 13 seconds left. Just like that, we take the lead. But it's 13 seconds left. He has three timeouts. One of the biggest mistakes I make right here is kicking the ball out of the end zone. If I kick it short, make him use 1 or 2 seconds to return the kick. If I do that, it dwindles down his chances. First play, I go coverage instead of blitzing, and look what happens. Boom, corner route, just like that. He's close to field goal runs. Next play, I'm sending to everybody, and he throws literally like I was the receiver. Catches it. Field goal range. Game over. Look at this throw. Just right, literally like I was the receiver. Send everybody. Make a guess. He guessed passed and just threw and dotted me. He did throw that slant route to Okoye earlier. That's pretty much what I was going to. Didn't expect him to throw right to me. But he did. Worked out. He called his timeout. 4 seconds left. He's actually going to hit this game-winning field goal. GG's in the chat. GG's below. I did lose this game. I did let myself down. Now, when I look back at this game, I will tell you it's a few things. One, I have to kick that ball. I have to get better special teams. A lot of these kids kick the ball to like the 5 yard line, make me return it into all their enforcers. I'm not that good at that. I gotta get better at that. Two, keep, I told you guys, I trust the system, trust my defensive philosophies, keep it up. First and 10 right there with 13 seconds. I played cover three cloud, relied on a linebacker in a cloud zone to cover a corner route, and it was bad. So that's another thing I did wrong in this game. But like I said, it was a great game, super entertaining, was not the outcome we wanted, but I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that like button. Feel free to subscribe if you love the content on the channel.